lot of single beautiful ladies here. Single ladies, make some noise where you at. Fellas, I'm gonna start this off real simple. Whatever you do, don't lie to these women out here. Stop lying to these women. I'm gonna just say that right out. Stop lying to them. You gotta learn what I learned. You gotta play the numbers game. See, I was reading the USA Today the other day, the census report for 2014. It said that in this country, there are 160 million women and only 120 million men. So that means 40 million of you women ain't gonna have no man. I don't give a damn what your pastor said. It ain't gonna happen. It ain't gonna happen. It ain't gonna matter. But you know what I'm gonna tell you this? This thing that kills it all the time. You got to realize, you got to play the numbers game. Keep it real with them. That ratio puts the ratio for fellas, for every single brother, it's like 20 women for you. That's 19 different combinations of happiness you could have. Oh, but it gets better. Oh, but it gets better. For every dude that get married, he forfeit his 20 women. Now it's like 40 to 1. Then you got to think about all the dudes that's done sold dope out here trying to be a dope boy. They went to the penitentiary. They forfeit their 20 women. Now it's like 60 to 1. Oh, it ain't even better. You in Atlanta. We in Atlantas. Yeah. Now think about all the gay dudes. Yeah, that gay dude, he can't be gay by himself. Both them forfeit their 20 women. Now it's like 40 to 1. The ratio of 100 women to one man. What these women want from a nigga? What, somebody let me know? Now you gotta make the right decision. Ladies, if you wanna get chose, don't feel discouraged. All you gotta do is remember two simple techniques. You gotta stop being lazy. I like my plate. Learn how to fix a man plate. Who likes sweet potatoes in here? Macaroni and cheese. Yeah, dressing, I like that. I like greens, but you know what I don't like? I don't like everything on my plate that tastes like fucking greens. Scoop that green juice out and stop letting it touch everything on my plate. My plate tastes like a green juice gumbo now. Yeah, I like deviled eggs. I eat them right up. I throw them right in my mouth. I'm, ooh, deviled egg. What this heifer didn't realize is she done put my deviled egg in the microwave on 3 minutes. Now the top of my mouth is getting burnt the fuck up. I'm hot. Top of my mouth burnt up because you didn't want to take that deviled egg out the microwave. Don't nobody like no hot deviled egg? Real simple. One chick passed over. I appreciated her going downtown trying to hook me up, give me some head. Everybody like head. Fellas like head. What I didn't appreciate is, in 25 years of living, she had learned the technique that was real simple. Tuck her teeth. Now, you digging the top of your teeth in the top of my dick. I ain't got no dick skin left, because you scraping all the dick skin I got off. Dick skin is this thin. It's like onion skin. It's gone. Tuck your teeth. That's all you got to do, is tuck your teeth. I want to punch you in your mouth, knock your teeth out, so I can get to some gums. Frustrating. You know, when you go downtown and hook your dude up, don't be lazy with it. Put your hands into it. Flap your rings like a butterfly. Grind that pepper up, because there's blessings in there. Yeah, new car, new hair, big house. All the things you want, Beyonce ticket concert. Just get in there, stop being lazy. It's all right there for you. You gotta realize, fellas, when dealing with women, you gotta understand that they are born with gifts we don't have. First thing they got a best friend. They best friend, every woman here got a best friend that's down to ride or die from them. If you got a best friend here, make some noise. Look at this. Look at them. They hugging. So that's loyalty right there. They'll die for them. See, they better friends than us, fellas. I met my girl's best friend the first day I met her. Her name's Keisha, and I want to fight her every time I see her. She's trying to destroy my relationship. I know it. I met her on the first day. I'm out at the club giving my woman drinks. I'm like, this is going to be my woman. I'm trying to get up out of here. I'm like, hey, you want to get up out of here? She was like, yeah, we can get out of here. I'm a little tipsy. Here come Keisha out of nowhere, crazy and ghetto. She good. Thank you. Thank you, we good, thank you. We don't need nobody. She don't even like your type. You like light skin. She like dark skin, tall, bald-headed dudes. You ain't even her type. I'm like, damn, I wasn't even talking to you. Fellas, we ain't friends like that. I've been friends with Charles since I've been in the seventh grade. Charles in the club drunk talking to something that ain't his type. I'm not finna save him. Charles could be in the corner talking to something that look like Caitlyn Jenner mixed with RuPaul. First thing I'm finna do, I'm finna pull my cell phone out. Oh boy, you out here wilding tonight, huh? Facebook Live, you see this boy like the transvestites out here, boy. Kissing him out, Charles, don't be afraid. I done ruined Charles' life. Messed up. Because we not loyal, we not down like that. I'm gonna tell you another thing women have. Women have intuition. Oh man, they got a gift from God. And it hit them like the Holy Ghost when it come over. Oh yeah, your woman got it. Don't even matter if she been to church or not, she has it. You can't lie, I lied, made a mistake. Told my woman I was gonna be working late one night. I'm out doing something I ain't had no business doing. Out with another woman. She at the crib folding clothes, believing my little lie, just watching TV. This is crazy. Just watching this empire, seeing what Lucius finna do, this is finna happen. That's when it hit her. Ooh, what is it, God? Ooh, what is it? Ooh, Sada Isa Papa, ooh, Father. Ooh, what is it, Jesus? Ooh, God, what is it? Ooh, ooh, Jesus, what is it, God? Ooh, speak to me, God. Ooh, speak to me. Ooh, I see bottomless appetizers, God. Leave me there, Jesus. Ooh, leave me there, Jesus. Ooh, 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 ooh. Ooh, chilies, Father. Leave me there, Jesus. Leave me there, back table, God. Leave me there, Jesus. Ooh, what is it, God? Ooh, some nappy-headed heifer with a lace front. Get my keys, get my purse. Yeah, now it's on. Now it's on. First thing she called Keisha up. She picked that phone up. She and Keisha right up. Keisha, girl, I need you. Where are you? Keisha, I feel like Billy is out here with another woman. Something ain't right. Here come Keisha, crazy and ghetto to the rescue. Bitch, don't worry about it. I'm already outside your house. Look outside. Look out your window. Look down here. You see me? He gonna learn. Come on downstairs. I knew some bullshit was gonna happen today because my period was late and I read my horoscope. It said, real women gotta do real things. Bitch, I am here. He gonna learn he can't fuck over us like that. When I get in a relationship with both of y'all? Now she done went down to the car, both of them in the car, they praying. My girl starts off. Neither one of them been to church. My girl just, dear Lord Jesus, Father God, just help me, God. I'm confused, I don't know what's happening. Here come Keisha with her ghetto ass. Dear Lord Jesus, Father God, strike this bitch ass nigga down for the stuff he did to my girl, cause my girl is a what, good bitch. You're like, what? Jesus like, are you cussing in your prayers? Who is this woman using my name in vain like that? Oh, it ain't over there. That's when the conversation rolled over to Facebook. Ladies, y'all know how y'all do. Nothing stays self-contained. Them fires don't stay isolated. It's all on Facebook. She putting this sub-tweet conversation all on Facebook. It's all out there. First of all, to the woman that's out here running around with my man, at Billy Sorrells, hashtag you a hoe, hashtag you ain't got no home training, hashtag we gonna deal with you, hashtag me and Keisha, hashtag that's my girl, hashtag Mayweather, watch the dummy, bitch, watch the dummy, hashtag we gonna jump you, hashtag world star, it's gonna be a video, but we ain't tripping though, because we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Jesus, like, I did not approve this message. Nah, it's, my daddy, he's trying to help me out. He done hit me. He said, hey, boy, they got you jammed up on Facebook. What you gonna do? He's like, get out of there. Cold 10, it's a problem. Get out of there, boy. So I don't know. I'm in there. I'm trying to figure out what I'm gonna do. I'm trying to figure out what the waitress ain't brought my check back yet. She ain't on it. She on Facebook. Yeah, I got his check, girl. He ain't gonna be able to leave. She keep walking by me. I'm sitting there like, damn, this bitch keep walking right by me. But I thought I was gonna get out. It was too late. My girl had already came in. I knew she was mad because she had her head turned at the 90-degree angle. Whenever your woman has that 90-degree angle head turn, it's a problem. She come walking in. Really? Really? Oh, really? That's what you want to do? Keisha right behind her. Really? Really? Really, nigga? Really? Really? Okay. That's fine, though. That's fine, though. Do you? Do you? Really? 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 Bitch, I'm dead. Bitch, I'm dead. Really? You, that's what you want to do? That's what you want to make up? That's fine. Do you? I'm sitting there trying to get out. It's like, man, I don't even know what's going on right now. That's when she asked me the critical question. If you ain't got nothing to hide, let me see your phone then. Fellas, let me tell you something. Whenever your woman asks to see your phone, it's like you're getting stabbed in the club and you don't know who's doing it. Let me see your phone. Oh. Is that what this is about, huh? I had to switch it on her. You know how you trying to make a woman feel crazy when she asks you a simple question? Let me see your phone. Oh, you want this phone, huh? Oh, this is what you want. You want to see this phone? You think this phone give a damn about you? I love you. This phone don't care about you. Oh, you want this phone? Oh, you want this phone? Fuck this phone. Fuck this phone. I'm trying to destroy the evidence. Fuck this phone. You're going to learn to stop messing with me. I thought I was out of there. Thought I was good. What I didn't know was Keisha went to ICDC College with a degree in TV, VCR, and cell phone repair. This bitch done super glued the phone back together, and it's going through my text messages when I come home. We seen what you said. Real women do real things. I was like, this is some bullshit. I can't escape this. Fellas, you can't lie. Don't even try it. We don't got that type of help. Ladies, I ask you simply, if you want to get a dude really on your side, be honest with us. You know, don't be afraid to tell us who you really are. When we meet your family, let us know you got crazy people in your family. I can't be the only brother that's got popped up on by crazy people. Went to meet my girl's family for the first time. I flew to Chicago, barbecue, 4th of July. She was like, hey, I want you to go meet my grandma. She's right over there. Go talk to her. I said, cool. Nobody trying to tell me what's going on, what the problem is. The only person who's talking to me is her grandfather, but his lingo is so old, I don't understand what he's saying. I walk over. I say, hey, ma'am, how you doing? She said, what's your name? I said, Billy. She said, where are you from? I said, Texas. She said, you know what, Billy's from Texas. The Lord has put a blessing on my heart. I'm going to go fix you a barbecue plate. She walks off. The granddaddy starts saying, hey, the CD got a scratch in it. The CD got a scratch in it. Hey, let me tell you something. She got the car, but she don't got the keys. I said, what you talking about? She comes back over. She starts in again. She said, hey. I said, hey. She said, what's your name? I said, Billy. She said, where are you from? I said, Texas. She said, you know what, Billy, I'm gonna fix you a barbecue plate. She walks off, he starts it again. Hey, hey, she got the elevator, but it don't go to the top. She got the table, but it don't got the chairs. I said, man, why don't you just tell me this woman got Alzheimer's? Hey, you the one came over here trying to be part of the goddamn family. See what the hell I've been dealing with all this time. Like, let us know what's going on with you. I ain't afraid. I mean, fellas, we try our best to please our women. Where my brothers had to go downtown here, where you at? If you ain't afraid to go downtown to please your woman here, where my brother's going downtown eating. I see this brother right here. He ain't afraid. It's always that one African. He gonna go all the way. I'm gonna eat the pussy. I'm not afraid of it. Where is it at? Somebody give me the pussy. I'm not afraid to eat the shit. Who has the pussy? Bring it to me. Gotta be careful, man. If you wanna please your woman, don't be afraid. We are down to please you. I'm not afraid to go downtown and hook you up. You know? But it's rough down there sometimes. Don't get tricked. They'll trick you. I was down there one time. I'm going to town. I'm. You know, you got that fast motion. You. Take you about 15 years to learn that right there. I'm down there. I'm doing my thing. You know, you down there so long, your them legs start crushing on your head. You can't hear something. It's like you in a damn fish tank. You can't hear nothing. I'm down there so long, my mouth start drying out. Like, I done got cerebral palsy. Like, I got Down syndrome. I'm. Hey. 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 Hey, hey, hey. Only thing that's gonna cure that is a kiss. I come up to try to get a kiss, she gonna turn her head like she don't know where the hell I been. She's talking about, nah, I'm good. I'm good. I'm good. What you mean you ain't good? This is you. You don't wanna see what you serve in the community? You don't wanna see what you feed in the streets? This is you. You act like I got a mouthful of Flint water or something. This is you. You act like I licked the handrail on the martyr bus. This is you. I try to keep it going. I try to put my little stuff in. She gonna tell my aunt, we gotta be safe. We gotta take this, you gotta put a condom on. I'm like, for what? Bitch, I done swallowed the disease. The disease is in my trachea. I knew it back. My throat start closing up right away. I can't. So I've been there. I can't. Help me, please. You start calling for help for people you don't know. Barack, Michelle, somebody, anybody. Help me, please. Cataract, B-Shack, Abednego. My throat is gone. I know what's going on. I walk in the job the next day. I can't even talk to nobody. I walked in there. Oh, what the fuck is going on with my throat? Damn, look at my damn throat. My shit is closed shut. It's over. It is over. I done got tricked. There's a lot of people in here, man, want to make the night magical. Comedy is all about making everything sex and have a good time. Don't be afraid. If you want to put some spice back in your life, you got to learn the two techniques that I got for you. Two techniques that's going to take your sex game to the next level. Listen to me, brother. This can save your life right here. Listen to me, big dog. You gotta listen to me. First thing out, fellas, you gotta breathe. If you don't breathe, you're gonna be out of there quick. You gotta, you know what I'm saying? You gotta let that off you. Homie right here, pay attention to me. You gotta breathe. You in there, you doing your thing. You, you gotta let that off you. My little white homie right here. You, oh my God, this is incredible. You gotta breathe, dog. My African brother, over the way, over the while. You gotta do your thing. Ladies, your job, just listen to your man. He gonna tell you everything you need to know. We be trying to tell y'all to slow down and make it magic. Y'all be listening, we be, wait a minute, baby, that's it. Wait a minute, slow down. Hold on, you're doing too much. Don't move like that. What y'all do? Oh, you want this pussy, wanna fuck with me, wanna fuck? You wanna fuck? You wanna get it? I want you right here. I want you right here. You wanna get it? We sitting there twin around, still on it, still on it. I'm. Nigga, you turn into a German Shepherd. You done turned into a German soldier. Keep Nasara, keep Nakara. I'm done. Give me 15 minutes, I'm gonna tell you that stuff. You ain't finna do shit in 15 minutes. 15 minutes, you are going to sleep. You asked for that one thing, right? Reach under there and give me that wash rag. You got that one wash rag that's under your bed. It's so hard and crusty. When you put water on it, it come back to life like an old English statue. It's, I am the towel. Who have summoned me from thy chamber to wipe thy belly clean, to clean up thy gooey stomach? I am the towel. Can't be afraid. Can't be afraid. Thing I love most, man, is that, you know, I've learned who I am. I accept that my life decisions made me who I am today. I'm married, happy, but I've been hurt before. It's two types of people in this world. It's two types of men specifically. Men that have been cheated on and men that have actually physically seen their woman with another dude. I'm the latter, y'all. It happened to me at an early age. I was 19, thought I was balling. I was working at Olive Garden, making $120 a day. With $120 a day at 19, you think you the man. Went to the club, found this young lady. Here's a message for you, fellas. When you go out and you think you're trying to find a woman to go home with, you gotta make sure that this woman does one thing before she leave with you. You need to make sure that she checks in with somebody before she go. If any woman says, hey, I'm down to get out of here and just walk off with you, she's homeless and she's looking for somewhere to stay. I'm gonna tell you that right now. No woman leaves with just anybody. She gonna walk over to her homegirl, even if you're ready to go, she gonna say, hold on one second, let me talk to my girls right quick. You see the dude with the red jacket? Let me tell you something. I'm about to get in the car with him. If I get on the freeway and wave my hands like this, bitch, he is trying to kill me. Call the police. You never go home with the girl with her bag already packed. She got the big purse with everything in it. Extra pair of panties. I try to take her home, she gonna tell me, I said, you need to go by the house and get anything? She's like, no, I'm good, I got everything I need. I was like, damn, what you mean? She was just going home with anybody tonight, huh? That's the one I'll go home with. We hang out, I try to make a relationship out of it, some kind of way. At 19, I done got a key to this woman's house. Think I'm balling. Tell you right now, heartbreak. Good pussy will make you make bad decisions. I'm telling you right now, fellas. I was working at Olive Garden. I called her one night. I was like, hey, I'm gonna get off. I'm gonna come over there and see you. First thing she said, she was like, hold up. I think I'm going out with my girls tonight. So I'll call you back at 11:30. 11:30 comes and goes. She ain't called me back. My homeboy hit me up and said, hey, Bill, I see your girl's friends up here at the club, but I don't see her. My stupid self, oh, you know what? Baby probably fell, a little tired, went to sleep, forgot to call me. I'm a surpriser. I'm gonna pack her up a dinner and bring it to her with her favorite dessert. So here go my little goofy ass. I got a bag full of Olive Garden, packed to the brim, dressed with my waiter outfit on. I done grabbed her favorite dessert, cheesecake, strawberry, don't even eat it to this day. Stop by the grocery store, what I pick up? Bouquet of flowers. Now let me tell you something, I'm taking chances to be with this woman. I don't wanna talk about people who are hood, but she from the hood. Her neighborhood is so tough, people will lean on your car and don't even know you. Car ain't even got to stop moving. They just be on you. The little dude, dope dealers be in front of the house, smoking weed, talking to you. What's up, boy? See you coming over here to see your girl, huh? Now I'm over there. I get to the front door. I go to put my key in, straighten the bottom lock. Bottom lock unlocked, but the door won't open. I'm like, what's going on? Top lock is on. Baby probably was scared because all the hood dudes in front of our house locked the top lock. I'm going to go around to the back. I start walking, freeze. Every man knows the sound that they woman make when they being pleasured. They know the sound that they make. This sound I ain't never heard before. This shit sound like punishment. Sound like pain. I come around the corner and what do I see? I see this dude from New Orleans, shirt off, braids hanging down, oiled up. He got New Orleans on his back. Katrina can't stop me. Cash money running shit for the 99 and 2000. Straight up out the Noya, bruh. And he doing a motion, looked like he was stirring up some gumbo. I thought it was the gumbo straw. I'm like, you know what? My stupid ass, this must be a rape. Help, somebody trying to rape baby. They raping baby out here. I guess he figured he saw me. He looked over his shoulder. He just opened up to show me how much dick he was putting in her. I broke down to hit my chest. I said, take some of that back out. Take some of that back out. She can't take all that. Oh, no. Please, Mr. Evacuee, please take some of that back out of there. I see you got your FEMA check on the ground, please. And from that moment, I was ruined. Only person I could talk to get some sound advice was my grandfather. But my grandfather, he's from the old school. no cell phone, no nonsense type of fella. He told me straight up, when I come in the room, I'm crying like I'm Trey off Boys in the Hood. Granddaddy, she there.
He said, hey, boy, you hold your goddamn nuts up. Now, let me tell you something. I see you crying. Young lady done messed over you. Let me tell you something. When life gives you lemons, well, shit, you better have some vodka close by, because lemonade ain't going to do a goddamn thing for you. Think about it.
I'm like, what the hell?
Hey.
I'm like, well, Granny, what you mean?
Hey, let me tell you something. You got to get back out there. You got to get back out there and find you somebody else. If you want to fuck your neighbor, you got to go outside. Think about it.
Like, what? I said, Granddaddy, now first of all, my granddaddy type of dude, he don't pressure his wife. Him and my grandmother been together 40 years. They go places like this, they don't even sit by each other. My grandmother be at a table like this, my granddaddy be in the lobby at the bar. So I asked him right then, I said, well, granddaddy, if you really love grandma, you know what I'm saying, you telling me to find somebody else and pick it up, you don't even sit by her when you go places.
Hey, get out of my goddamn business, okay? Everything is fine in my relationship. Let me tell you something.
I said, well, how you really love her? You don't really be under her like that.
Hey, let me tell you something. Flip that light switch right there. Don't it turn on and off? Well, shit, that, damn it, that's love then. See, if I ain't give a shit about your grandma, she be sitting here in the goddamn dark. Let me show you this card. I got this card right here. You see this card? This credit card. It goes right to Sears and Roebuck. She got $700 over there at Sears and Roebuck. I said, don't you mean Sears? Hey, get out of my goddamn business. I'm trying to tell you. There's another card right here, Montgomery Ward. That's right, Montgomery Ward. I said, Montgomery Ward is closed, granddaddy. Hey, I don't give a goddamn. She got credit if they open it back up. So you need to get your life together.
Different day, different age. Now they believe that the devil is in the details. Oh, yeah, that's what women believe, that the devil is in the details. I come in from a basic job. I was working at FedEx, delivering boxes. Real simple job. But because of the stuff that I'm putting my woman through in my relationship, she wouldn't ask me about my day. When a woman asks you about their day, she don't give a damn about your day. She don't give a fuck what you've been going through. She's listening for a lie. That's it. She listening for a lie. I had a simple job. I moved boxes all day. I left at 7:30, came home 7:45. Who at the door? Want to see what's going on with me. Fake smile. Hey. So tell me about your day. What happened to you today?
Wanna know about my day? Oh, it was just a basic day at FedEx. That's all I did. I just moved some boxes. That's all I was doing.
Well, tell me about your day. What happened today? You left this morning at 7:30. It's 7:45. You're just now coming in. What happened today?
Okay. Got up. Well, I got up this morning at 6:15 because I knew that I'd be working at 7:30. When I got there, he told me I was going to be training a little Mexican dude named Jose. Around this time, it's about 8:15. I told Jose, let me tell you something, partner. You need to do what I say when I take you to do it. I'm going to train you, but you ain't going to make me look bad on the job because my daddy and my granddaddy both work for this company. You understand what I'm saying, Jose? No problem, my friend. I work here. I kind of do what you tell me to. It's no problem. I do what you say. It's all good. I'm going to move what you tell me. I said, let me tell you something, Jose. You need to learn how to move these boxes. These boxes going to Georgia. These boxes going all the way over here to Fort Wayne, Indiana. These boxes going all the way to Florida. You understand? No problem, my friend. I moved the boxes. It's no problem. Around this time, it's about 10:15. I looked at my watch. I realized that day was the 15th. I got to go call the car note people because I'm tooting the car notes behind. So I called the car note people up. I said, hey, I'm going to make that car note payment today. They told me, Mr. Rizzo, if you don't make that car note payment today for $225 for both of them, we're going to pick up your goddamn car. I said, bullshit, bitch. No, you won't. I almost got that car paid off. I got 3 more payments to make on my goddamn truck. You ain't going to make me take my car away from me like that. I said, cool. So I hung up with her. I went to go talk to my supervisor. And around this time, it's about 11:15. I go talk to the supervisor. I said, supervisor, you got them overtime hours for my check? He said, yeah. Come back around 1:30, 2 o'clock. I had your check ready for you. I said, cool. I go back in there to check on Jose. I almost slipped when I walk in the room. He done mopped the goddamn floor. All the boxes moved from over here to over there. The forklift done moved to the side. He outside up under the manager truck trying to give his truck a goddamn oil change. I come outside. I say, Jose, what you doing, Jose? You need to go and take a break right now. He said, no problem, my friend. I take a break right now. I'm going to eat my lunch right here. My wife made my lunch for me. She made me tacos, beef, and chicken. I asked you last night, baby, put my wings up that I got from Wingstop. What you do? Left my wings out on the counter all goddamn night long. I want to eat my wings, but I was scared to eat my wings. You know why? Because if I'd have ate them and they'd been sitting out all night, I'd have got salmonella poison. If I got salmonella poison, I ain't got no sick days. I ain't got no sick days because I take your grandma all the way out to the goddamn country when your punk ass brother could have took out to the goddamn country. But you know what? I ain't worried about that because I'm going to tell you about the stuff he pulled over me on the holiday season. But you know why I don't mess with him? So what I did, I only had $3, but I had $3 in 3 different accounts. I had $1 in my Wells Fargo, $1 in my Bank of America, and $1 in my Chase. So where I went to Wendy's. Went to go get me something from Wendy's. I told the lady, I said, put the burger on one car, put the fries on another car, and put the drink on another one. Your best friend Keisha in the winter talking about, I don't think I can do all that. I say, bitch, put the food in the bag. Stop trying to ruin my life. So I ate my little burger, drunk my little drink. I'm
driving back to the job. Who I see outside painting outside of FedEx, Jose, he out there doing his damn thing. He got two of his homeboys, they changing the colors of FedEx from purple and orange to red, white, green like the Mexican flag. I say, Jose, he ain't stop. I said, Jose, he ain't stop. I said, fuck it, do your thing. I went in there, talked to the boss. Boss had my check ready for me. I took it over to Bank of America, had to put my thumbprint on my check. Mm-hmm. Had to sign the back of the check. Mm-hmm. All because your brother gave me them fraud-ass checks over the holiday season. Talk about he know how to turn 200 into 2,000. So I go over there, I slide my check on the thing. She gonna tell me that I had an overdraft fee for $35. On top of another overdraft fee for $35. On top of another overdraft fee for $35. They was gonna take $275 out of my check. I said, Brenda, get my goddamn check back, Brenda. Get my check back. Slide my shit back under the window. I went right over there to the liquor store. They got the check cash replaced on the inside. Paid that money to be at Western Union. Told them hoes kiss my ass. Now I got three more payments to make, and I'm walking in the house right now. It is 7:45. How was your day, baby? Here she go. Wow, really? That's what you're gonna tell me? First of all, if you had a problem with what I was doing, you could have got your punk ass up and went and walked them wings to the refrigerator on your own self. But the question I wanna know is, you say you ate your burger, right? And you say you drunk your drink, but who the fuck ate the fries, bitch? Who ate the fries? Who ate the fries? Who ate them, though? Tell me that. Who ate them? I don't know. I don't know who ate the fries. No clue. I'm done. Busted. Now I gotta figure my life out. I'm gonna say this, I'm gonna get out of here, man. I live in Los Angeles, I'm chasing my dreams, but I believe I can really make it. I believe I can make it in this industry by putting together a dope film. Y'all got dope actors and dope people in Atlanta doing dope stuff. And I think I can make it happen. I just want to take you into my world and show you a trailer I want to give you. This is a trailer for my movie, a dope, it'll make it big blockbuster film. Get your popcorn ready. Coming this summer. Because all movies come out in the summer. Fox New Line Home Cinema presents the story of one man on his mission to save the world. This summer, Denzel Washington is Jesus. Denzel walk out in that Last Supper scene. Judas, can I talk to you for a second, please? Judas, you disloyal, disrespectful, bitch-made, fool-ass nigga. You think you can lie to me like that, huh? You don't believe my father's making a mansion with many rooms with streets of gold? You think you can sit up here and lie to me like that in my own face? You know what you want to do? You will get somebody and go talk to them. Starring as Judas. Give it up for DMX. Yo, G's. I don't know. No Pontius Pilate, dog. The brother's lying. You gonna sit up here and lie to me like that in my own face? You don't believe I got 11 sets of disciples? That's 11 sets of personalities? You were supposed to be number 12, huh? Now you go get Peter and tell Peter to come in here. Starring as Peter, Morgan Freeman. Mr. Leviathan, get the chains out the door, Mr. Leviathan. Cold 10. The enemy is here. I say Eastside, be on time. E-A-S-T. Because your name came up, and your name came up. I don't need you to jump for me. You go get Paul and tell Paul to come in here. Starring as Paul, Chris Rock. I can't believe that a child of nail my savior to the cross. This is some bullshit right here. I tell you what, if Jesus is white, everything will be all right. You know what? I don't need you to do anything for me. I want you to remember one thing and one thing only. Moses ain't got nothing on me. Passion of the Christ, too. I'm Billy Sorrells. That's my time, y'all.